We are back again. This time we'll do a longer and a more relaxed stretching, or as we call relaxation of the muscles using yoga asanas. So we have Marcela back. And Marcela loves running. Did I tell you before?
Are you enjoying the first universe?
Seventh anniversary.
Seventh anniversary.
So she is going to join for the seventh anniversary run, which we have on the 2nd July. Have you registered, guys? If you haven't, please do so. So let's move on for the longer and more relaxed stretches. Largely, you should be doing this on the same day of the run, or perhaps you can do on the next day as well after all your after run party is done. So what do you do normally? To begin with, let's do a light warm up, just doing 3 rounds of Surya Namaskars. Right now, we will just do 1 round. So how you do it is, we start with Namaskar Asana. Inhaling all the way up into Hastottanasana. Exhaling, go release your back into Hastapadasana. Take your right leg back into Ashtasanchalan. See that the body parts are getting stretched. Then both the legs go at the back. Both the legs at the back into Dandasana or the plank pose. Then go into Ashtang Namaskar. Inhaling, come up into Bhujangasana, then exhaling down into Downward Dog. Excellent. See, stretching the entire body, your hamstrings, and releasing the back. Then get your right leg in front into Ashtasanchalana. Then left leg comes in front into Hastapadasana. Inhaling all the way up and relax. So do at least 2 to 3 rounds in a very relaxed manner so that your body gently warms up. Then we will move on to some of the core stretches. The first and the foremost is Kapotasana, one of the piriformis and your quadriceps as well. The quadriceps are getting stretched here as well. Hold all the stretches for at least 10 counts. And in this case, you can also stretch it for 30 seconds. Breathe normally. Be in the flow. There's no hurry. You have all the time in the world to just do this now. Come back. Now the second that we're going to do is called Ajneyasana, or the low lunge. Again, it's going to stretch back on your IT band, on your quadriceps. Very good for ankle flexing. Stretching and opening up of the back. Again, hold it for 10 to 30 seconds in normal breathing. Now let's move into the lying down poses. Don't go immediately on your back. Go on your side, then go on your back. Start with a full body stretch or Yastikasana. Take your hands all the way up. The hands go on the floor. The ankles are stretched in front. Let's do some ankle work here. Stretch both the back. Then one at the back and one in front. Take them clockwise. Anti-clockwise. Our knees, ankles and our hips are taking all the pounding when we are running. It's important to stretch them. Now with exhalation, come back to the normal. Now what we did while standing after the run, the Hastpadangushtasana series, we'll do the same right now. What happens when we are standing? If our postures are not right, we will not be able to stretch our hamstrings right. So in my opinion and experience, the best hamstring stretch happens when you are sleeping or in the lying down position, because you are isolating your hamstrings. So we will do the same stretch while sleeping or lying down. if you cannot do this, you can use a belt or a dupatta as well. She's flexible. Poses on our spine. It's up, again going to work on the IT band as well. So put your hands in T position, exhaling. Take both your knees on one side. So it's again stretching, twisting your and releasing your back. It's also stretching on your IT band on the other side. Back. One more to stretch your IT band and also to release your back. We normally do this backward bending. So get your knees closer to your hips. Get hold of your knees if you can and then get your hips up in the air. Setu Bandhasana. So it's working on your IT band, it's working on your quadriceps, it's also working on your back. Gently release. So it's good for your lower back mobility. And now what we do, we now work on the lower back with Pavad Mukhtasana. Very good for the lower back release and mobility. With one leg and then the other leg. Get it as close to the chest as possible. Both the legs are fully engaged. Engage that leg as well. Sink towards you. Now both the legs together. Excellent. Excellent. Yes. Release. Now you can gently get up on your side and go into Supta Virasana. It's very difficult to start attempting it with only one leg first. She's flexible, so she can do it. So you have to sit. Your ankles have to come out. Very good for ankle mobility. And then gently go on your back. Just come up and show with one leg first. If you cannot do it with both legs, you can do it with one leg also. Yes. Extremely relaxing posture releases your quadriceps, releases the pressure, and stretches your ankles. And if you can do the both, just show with the both. Please follow a bit cautious approach while doing it. It requires a good range of ankle mobility to do this. Excellent. And you can relax here. So then slowly come out of the posture. So now you can relax either. Close to the wall as possible and take your legs up the wall and then relax. You can also take your hands up and relax. Take your hands up. Get your hips close to the wall and get your legs on the wall. So it helps in releasing the blood. times walking in office or in kitchen can be in this position for as long as 10 minutes, 15 minutes, as you wish. That's it. Come back now. So that's it from our side. Thanks a ton. Thanks, Marcella. And I hope to see you on 2nd July.
Yeah? Sure.
Okay, bye-bye.